movie Rex Reed called the most horrifying motion picture I have ever seen. The Texas Chainsaw Massacre from New Line Cinema.
We're here at Texas Frightmare Weekend 2009 with the legendary Marilyn Burns, all right, of Texas Chainsaw Massacre. Marilyn, how does it feel to be here talking about this film that you did back in 1973?
Who would have ever thought that would happen? It's amazing to me. It still is.
It's awesome. I mean, and, you know, we've talked about your performance, you know, earlier today, you and I, and, I mean, you conveyed such panic and terror and such in those final frames. I mean, as an actress, where were you drawing from?
The whole situation on the set.
Right, right.
The heat, the frustration, the
Texas filmmaking.
Yeah, exactly.
It
didn't take much to get it, yeah.
But, you know, I think it's amazing that this film has gone on to become such a mega cult hit. I mean, really. And I think when you guys were making it, I mean, there was no way you could have known that any of you that it was going
to
be.
No, we sure didn't. I mean, I just wanted to see it to get to the screen.
Yeah.
Most people just thought it was never getting anywhere.
Right, right.
So the fact that it still stands today and people still watch it,
it's pretty amazing.
It's
fantastic, and it's a testament to what is Texas independent. It's proof that a low-budget independent film can rock.
It does show you that.
It does.
Even though Hollywood wouldn't recognize it for years. But now it's in the AFI.
Right. Exactly.
It's huge, but for years they wouldn't even acknowledge it as existed.
But you know, I mean, I know that you went on to do Eaten Alive, also directed by Tobey Hooper. And it was shot very differently. It was on a soundstage, right?
Oh, yeah, that was real different.
It was a much more controlled kind of environment.
Definitely.
Want to pick up where we left off and talk a bit more about Helter Skelter. Helter Skelter, the miniseries, your character, is a fantastic portrayal.
I remember I was standing out in front of the gun room at this one point. And Charlie came up to me and pulled me off the porch. And he told me I needed a change of clothing, a knife, and my driver's license.
An additional change of clothing?
Yes.
And did you get these things?
Yes. And he told me to go with Tex and do what Tex told me to do, and I... I got into the car, and I believe Sadie and Katie were already in the back seat.
What is the next thing that happened?
Tex got in the car, and we started to drive away. And then Charlie said, "Leave a sign. You girls know what I mean. Something witchy."
Oh, well, thank you, George. That was totally different.
Yeah.
Because I'm not playing some made-up character. I'm
right.
Playing a real person that's still out there.
Yeah.
And because it was still so many years close to the actual happening, you wanted to be as accurate as possible.
Sure.
I had to figure how you could understand her. I know... CBS, Lorimar, Bugliosi all needed an angel, Linda Kasabian. I'm thinking,
right.
How can a lady that's been there both nights of both murders,
yeah.
The only one that's there both nights, thank you. So if you didn't get the idea the first night,
yeah.
If you're going to return
the second night, yeah.
You know what's happening, so don't sit. But yet she comes off as a little sweetheart.
Yeah.
And, that one was hard for me at first as an actress to figure how to do that.
How to portray that, yeah.
And I came around and got my way, but it did. But then, of course, and then seeing Steve Railsback play Charles Manson.
Oh, I was going to ask. It had to be kind of terrifying, you know, as actors.
He was terrifying, amazing.
You know, yeah, as actors, people say, in a horror film, you must have been terrified. It's really never scary on a horror film, but when you see somebody as intense as Railsback, as Manson, a figure that is,
that was one performance. And I remember in the courtroom scene.
Yeah.
I mean, this is live, watching him jump over the table.
It makes you want to run.
It's not a movie. It's real. Just amazed because this isn't something they created out of the fictional imagination of this happened. And so the whole horror of the whole incident was pretty
terrifying.
Pretty terrifying.
You bet.